Hello everyone, namaskar. So let's solve one more question from partial differential equation. It's a question from homogeneous partial differential equation with constant coefficient. So if I take del by del x as capital D and del by del y as d dash, so this will be d2 plus d dash minus 6 d dash square z equals to x plus y. Let's find the auxiliary equation. Replace d by m and d dash by 1. So m square plus 3m minus 2m minus 6 equals to 0. So m plus 3 minus 2 m plus 3 m plus 3 m minus 2 So from here you are getting m1 as minus 3 and m2 as 2. I can write my complementary function, which is f1 y plus m1x plus f2 y plus m2x. The process of writing complementary function is over now. Coming to the particular integral. So how to write that? Particular integral is 1 upon d square plus d dash minus 6 d dash square. This will operate on x plus y. So I will try to create first 1 plus x. Okay, that form in denominator. So if for that, if I take d square out, in denominator I will get 1 plus d dash by d plus 6 d dash square by d square, operating on x plus y. Now you can take this denominator to numerator, so power will be negative. One plus d dash by d plus 6 d dash square by d square, x plus y. Fine. Now let's check first that up to what term this power will be minus 1, because this has come from numerator. Up to what term we need to expand, because we know the expansion of 1 plus x power minus 1 that is 1 minus x plus x square minus x cube plus so on, but I don't need to write the entire expansion. Up to some term only I have to write. So as you can see, in numerator we have d dash, which is derivative with respect to y. So if I find d dash, if I differentiate x plus y partially with respect to y, I will get 1. If I do the double derivative partially with respect to y, I will get 0. So only first two terms will do, okay, because you see this d dash square, so this will also become 0. So because because third term is x square, so that will be d dash by d plus 6 d dash square by d square whole square, so every term will be of power 2. So that will for that I will need second derivative. Second derivative is 0. Okay, so I don't need to write terms from third term onwards, okay, because they are of no use to me. So my pi will be 1 upon d square, first term 1 minus second term is d dash by d plus 6 d dash square by d square. Even this is not needed, this second part 6 d dash square by d square is not needed, operating on x plus y. This dot 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 you can show that, because more terms will be there which I am not writing. So my pi will be 1 upon d square, 1 multiplied by, bring this x plus y inside, so x plus y minus d dash by d, operating on x plus y, I'm not writing the other term because that I know is 0. I've already shown you that. Okay. So okay. So pi is equal to 1 upon d square x plus y, first derivative with respect to y of x plus y I have already solved, that came out to be 1, so this will be minus 1 by d of 1, that means integration with respect to x of 1, that will give you x, so x and x will get cancelled. You are left with 1 upon d square of y. That means integration twice with respect to x of this y. So if you will integrate first time, you will get y into x. If you will integrate second time, you will get y x square by 2. So I know you know that very well how to integrate. You can do it orally here. In exam, if you get more time, you can write also inside that first derivative is y into x, second derivative is y into x square by 2. Because we have found pi, final is z equals to cf plus pi. What is my cf? F1 y minus 3x, f2 y plus 2x. F1 y minus 3x plus f2 y, what was there, plus 2x. And plus y x square divided by 2. That's it. So again, it was simple auxiliary equation. You all know how to find complementary function. You all have done a lot of practice of that. Coming to the particular integral, I have to form 1 plus x power something. So I took d square common from denominator, send that to numerator. So this was 1 plus x power minus 1 form. I also checked up to what term I need to expand. So I saw that up to second term is enough, because from third term onward it was becoming zero. So I expanded that way. Then I took x plus y inside. D dash is derivative with respect to y, so that was 1. Then 1 by d is integration with respect to x, so that is x. X plus x is x minus x gone. So 1 by d square is integration twice with respect to x, so that gave me y x square by 2. Finally, z equals to cf plus pi was my final answer. That's it. Do watch my playlist for more such problems. Thanks and have a nice day.